I'm watching the Roy siblings react to their father's sudden death, to the show, giving fans no time to recover from the shock. Let's talk about the heartbreaking scene from season 4 of Succession, which was completely unscripted. So here's what went down in this emotional roller coaster of an episode. Now, before we head down that road, let me explain why it happened. It seems director Adam McKay is all about improvisation when it comes to acting. He told The Hollywood Reporter that when he's casting, he makes sure to ask the actors if they're good at thinking on their own. The Oscar-winning director started shooting for the show with the same thing in mind, and all other directors followed his lead. It took a while, but the actors also started feeling comfortable with impromptu performances. And all of this led to a moment fans will not soon forget. The episode, Connor's Wedding, has managed to move the audience in a way that wasn't expected. Siblings were on a boat for the wedding, while their father, Logan Roy, gets on a plane to fly to Sweden for a business trip. That's when we see the terrible news reach the siblings, informing them that their father had collapsed, and the medical team was trying its best to revive him. The hopelessness and helplessness of his children were so obvious. I mean, this is Roy we're talking about. That man looked invincible. The denial we saw, despite that man being a terrible father, his children kept hoping that he'd get out of this bind too. Like he had a trick up his sleeve to fool death too. I think this made the scene more real, because this is exactly how any normal person would behave. The sudden loss, the part where they had to keep functioning like normal adults, unable to mourn a parent who's gone forever. It connected the audience with the actors in a very deep and profound way. The way their emotions were so obvious, it tugged at the hearts of the audience. Having to watch each sibling take a turn to try to say their last words to their father through a phone, while the medical team can be seen trying to revive Logan's heart. This moment made them so human. Unlike the manipulative and scheming personalities that we've seen from the start, this was real. It was raw emotion, and then time seemed to be at a standstill. When it was confirmed that he had died,
got very short of breath, and he was hurting, and then I don't want to bullshit you, Ken.
The scene at the end of the episode really made the moment even more emotional, was when siblings put their differences and conflicts aside to just embrace each other, because no one else in the world could know how it felt to lose their father. They were all scared of what the future held, and it showed. This huge tragedy, in the middle of the biggest tragedy, wasn't written down in any of the scripts. Can you believe that this brilliant piece of acting, which gave all their characters so much depth, was just something the actors felt was needed at the moment? And everyone played along. Even director Mark Mylod admitted that the shot made everyone on set very sentimental too. The moment became the talk of the town after the episode ended, partly because the audience lived off of the scarce emotional scenes between the siblings, and partly because of the way it was done. Even though there were many hints dropped here and there that something might happen to Logan Roy because of his deteriorating health, no one was expecting it to be this soon in the season and for it to happen so abruptly. Some fans are calling it the best episode on TV for the year 2023. The show is also now at the end of its journey, with only 4 more episodes to go, and fans are very sad to see it come to an end. It has given the audience a very memorable 3 seasons. From the first time the show aired, the fans fell into a love-hate relationship with the crazy family that consisted of a narcissistic father, Logan Roy, who was pretty much a D-bag to everyone, and especially to his kids, Kendall, Shiv, and Roman. The siblings, in turn, were seen constantly scheming against one another, sabotaging each other's plans, just to get their father's validation that they were intelligent and capable enough to inherit the Waystar Royko empire. That leaves us with the eldest sibling, Connor, who had no interest in acquiring his father's wealth or being a part of this ugly corporate game. Instead, he wanted to make a name for himself by trying to run for president, considering that he did not have any knowledge, which made him look like a complete buffoon for even trying. And the other 3 siblings took digs at him because he was so confused about what he wanted from life. I'm sure that at some point or another, anyone watching would have felt bad for him. But trust me when I say this, he was his own worst enemy. Not that any of the Roy siblings were any better. They were all on the same sinking ship. It all started with Logan's health, taking a hit on his 80th birthday. This put a strain on the siblings and their relationship, as the question of succession came into play. Kendall was made to step into his father's shoes for the time being, but he tried to completely take over. He attempted to get the board of directors to vote his father out, but unfortunately for him, it fails. Extremely distressed to be made to look like a fool, his sobriety takes a hit, and he's back to substance abuse. Needless to say, it didn't end well for him, and his recklessness leads to an accident in which a waiter dies. Logan decides to help his son out of the situation, but not out of concern. Instead, he uses the incident to make a deal with his son, which allows him to force Kendall out while retaining control of the company. How awful. I mean, who even thinks of doing that to their kid? But then again, it didn't surprise the viewers, as they knew how ruthless he could be. In season 2, Logan offers the CEO position to his daughter, Shiv, only to disagree when she publicly claims it. It's sad to see the children trying to make their father love them by scheming against each other to appear as ruthless as the megalomaniac father. What's even more shocking is that their dad seems to be enjoying it all, like a game of chess where he's moving his pawns. The cruise scandal and its cover-up were one of the most shocking things ever. It came out that the company has forced female employees to engage in physically abusive activities to extend their contracts. And with this, down the drain goes the PGM deal, from which Logan was trying to secure funds to keep the company afloat. But what was insane was that when investigations began, the family decided to throw Kendall under the bus, making him accountable for all of the mess. He was told to admit that it was his fault in a press conference, and he agreed, only to go nuclear. Instead of taking the blame, he very cleverly pinned all of it on his father in front of the entire world. The third season was the most brutal as compared to the previous two. It burned a lot of bridges between a lot of people. Logan, in an attempt to save his empire, decided to sell the company to a tech giant named Gojo. This meant that none of his children would get the company. And to stop this from happening, all three siblings finally got together, a moment that the audience had been anxiously waiting for. They tried to use their mother's divorce agreement to gain the power back, to stop the deal from happening. Heck, they even confronted their father, telling him he has failed. But Logan Roy always managed to be two steps ahead of them. As it turned out, he had already gotten in touch with the children's mother and convinced her to be on his side. Oh, when they found out how their mother had betrayed them, it was so sad. But the biggest betrayal came from someone unexpected. Shiv's husband Tom was the one who told him about the takeover plan for Logan Roy. He destroyed his relationship with his wife just to secure his position in the power struggle. Not that theirs was a solid relationship to begin with. They'd been drifting apart for quite some time, considering Shiv cheated on Tom. It seems that this was his twisted way to get back at her. The siblings fail, and it seems there's no stopping the company from going out of their hands. The show hasn't given the audience any time to recover. It kept coming back again and again with a strong storyline that always left everyone shocked and speechless. It was cutthroat and vicious. There's also no denying that Logan was, and still is, a very integral character in the show. Logan might have been a terrible father, but he was their father after all, and that's what makes season 4 so painful. Let's hope that the show ends on the same high note that it has maintained all these years. So, with the show giving fans no time to recover from the shock to watching the Roy siblings react to their father's sudden death, that's all we've got on how the heartbreaking scene in Succession Season 4 was unscripted.